The English language is a very interesting thing. Every day, certain words and phrases are used frequently. They are used a lot. So I thought today we would have a look at some of those phrases. For example, we might wish someone good luck by saying, break a leg. Quite often used in theatrical circles, but other people use it as well on a day-to-day basis. When we want to wish someone good luck, we will say, break a leg. If you are willing or if you want to offer to pay for something, you can say that that particular thing is on me. Maybe I take you out for a meal. And at the end of the meal, when the bill arrives, I say, that meal is on me. Maybe someone asks you a question that you don't know the answer to. You might say, I don't know. Or you might say, it beats me. That means, I have no idea. I do not know the answer to the question. Maybe you go out for a meal with some of your friends and you all decide to pay your equal share. We might say that you go Dutch. Catch up. If you catch up with someone, it means you are going to see that person later. I will catch up with you later. I will catch you later. It means I will see you again very soon. If you feel tired and exhausted after a busy day at work, you might say that you are dead tired. I've had such a busy day at work. I'm dead tired. Dead tired. You are exhausted. You might ask a person to leave you alone for a few moments. You might want them to go away and leave you to reflect on something. You might say to that person, give me a break. Give me a break. Please leave me alone for a few moments. Give me a break. Something that you don't agree with, something that you think is wrong, or maybe according to your opinion, you would disagree with. You might disagree with something. You might say that something is not in your books, not in my books, or not in my book. That thing you disagree with strongly. You don't think it is right. You don't think that thing is acceptable. Not in my books. Something you don't like, something you dislike, something that you find objectionable, you might say that thing is not your cup of tea. No, superhero movies, not my cup of tea. I don't really like them. If you ask a person to make a decision, maybe you want them to come to a decision very quickly. You might ask them or tell them to make their mind up. Do you want a cup of tea or not? Make your mind up. Finally, something that happens now and again, something that happens occasionally. Something that is very rare. It happens once in a blue moon. It happens infrequently. It doesn't happen very often at all. Something that does happen often, my English lessons, of course, and I hope you will join me again for another one very soon. This is Mr. Duncan in England saying, catch you later. Ta-ta for now.